This is the trail kitchen. Now, I know everybody's gonna say in this whole thing that, oh, it's expensive, oh, it's this and that, but let me tell you something. I will gladly pay for something that I'm fairly definitely sure is gonna last quite a long time over building something myself that I know will not be as good. I could build a wooden chuck box. I could do it. I've done drawers, I've done all that shit before, but it's not gonna be as good, and I can guarantee that. Will this be for everybody? No, but it's for me. And I'm gonna show you why. I started out in the back of this truck, an action packer, a stove that didn't fit in anything. I don't wanna say chaos, but it was kind of annoying. And then get my table out that was also separate, so you had to pull out a table. Or even if you carried a camp system of some sort with tables in it, you had to carry it separate. So you have that, then you have the action packer, which has your fuel, plates, pans, pots, all that kind of stuff. I wanted to get rid of all that, and I wanted something that was streamlined and pretty beefy. And this is what I chose. This is the Trail Kitchen, the middle size. There's a compact and there's one with built-in burners and all that kind of stuff. Let's set this up. Trail Kitchen is a company that builds their own kitchens. They're all made out of aluminum, a composite aluminum, which is aluminum sandwiched over another item to make it a composite. Stainless steel hardware. It's pretty beefy built. The coolest part about it for a Tacoma, or really any pickup, is that on the bottom of it, it's got some skids on it. And it allows you to actually have it sit in your bed rails without going side to side. So all you have to worry about is a forward to aft lateral movement. When you have an action packer or a Tupperware container, or you have a Rubbermaid container or something like that, you will have to worry about it moving side to side as well as front to back. Well, this gives you one version of that you don't have to worry about. Plus for off-roading, shit not flying around. The awkward thing for me that I figured is how to actually set it up. In order to set it up, you have to take off the very top, which are a pair of tables. So we're gonna go ahead and set this up now so you can see how I do it, and then you can tell me how I'm fucking up. So you have to take these top little knobs off, which are gonna hold your tables onto the kitchen when you put it back together. And then you're going to reveal your tables, basically. Now, what I did is typically these will actually just drop, but I added some Velcro so that when I lifted it up, it wouldn't just drop. And all you do is just pop it back up there and you're good to go. So you got to set this one aside. You've got two different types of legs. These are your table legs. Now, the way these work is this knob here, this goes up through the end, this knob goes on top, screws down, makes it nice and tight. Now, I thought is really cool. It's got this awesome little quick release setup where you just kind of pull it to where you need it, and it'll stop, and then you tighten it. This keeps it from moving. It's a slick little setup. Typically, I don't see this on setups. It's just these little things, and it gives you a little bit of play, and I don't know, it's just, it's a lot nicer. So you got three different settings, and if you want it even shorter for some reason, you can go up a little bit and then tighten it, but there's just no positive lock. So it's a really good array so that you can stack it on something if you need to, or if you have a box under it, whatever. The other type, actual kitchen leg, this part without the cap you see here, this side has one. This part goes into the kitchen, you tighten a tension knob of sorts, and it keeps it in there. You get two of these, and you get four of these. So you just loosen your tensioning knobs, you just loosen them enough so that you can just have them sit in there, and then slide it out some. Grab yourself two of the poles, stick it in, tighten her up. It's a pretty positive lock. Now, this is the part that I haven't gotten quite smoothed out well. From this point, you have to take the other two legs, transition from your truck bed or vehicle to the ground, and then put the legs in. There's no real elegant way to do this, so I just lift it out basically, let it rest on the legs, and do the same thing. So at this point, you have a pretty stable base. Now we're gonna put the rest of the stuff on. So this is the basic trail kitchen setup. This is pretty much the minimalist setup that you can have other than just setting it up on a box of some sort. With the legs in, we don't have the actual table sections out yet. So that's what we're gonna do now. So to do that, we need the two knobs we took off before, and we need the leg. So we'll put the actual table on, tighten it up, and then we just take the leg, stick it through the end, and tighten it down. At that point, you'd simply extend the lower leg, and now you have a rather sturdy table. So we're gonna repeat it on the other side. And again, extend this leg. And if you need it more, you can always extend it a little bit more. Like this side, I think I do. And this is your basic setup. And the door right here, we have a quite nice latch, I think. Doesn't really move or rattle or make a lot of noise. Your utensils. The utensil drawer has quite a bit of space. We only keep forks, spoons, measuring cups, steak knives, because who needs a regular knife? Some just miscellaneous stuff here. Regular utensils like spatulas and all that jazz, lighter, tongs, and I'm sure we'll add some more stuff. And there's a little space above it so that you don't have to worry about things getting all messed up and sticking and all that stuff. The system that I like to use is the GSI stuff. I like the Bugaboo campware. I'm really glad that it fits pretty much perfect under there without any dragging or anything like that. It's a nesting system, has a frying pan, has two big pans. All the lids have strainers built into them, as you can see right there. I like it. They work very well. I can't be happier. Snowpeak, obviously, because overlanding. For coffee, I use my MSR wind burner, or just to boil a little bit of water, whatever. And then we have a couple plates and bowls, which will eventually be replaced with Snowpeak because they're a little lower profile. And we have just general baby wipes to help clean stuff. And then we have our stove. Fits perfect right there. Does everything I need it to. It'll hold all your cooking supplies. Rubbermaid container that fits inside of here along with everything else. But it's good to have that storage ability. Now this keeps me from having to go to multiple places or multiple boxes or anything like that to get what I need. It also gives me a good cooking surface, a good prep surface, a good storage surface, and it just makes life easier. Now this unit is $699. It is expensive, don't get me wrong, but if you want one that just works, if you want something that is just built well and it's gonna last you for quite a while, then this is the way you wanna go. I have no issue just throwing this thing in my truck and not really worrying about it at all. It's an amazing piece of gear, and I look forward to using it quite a bit. A couple people have asked me, you know, what am I gonna do when I get the camper? Well, this will actually slide in the door, sit on the floor in the back of the camper, because I don't know about you, but I don't wanna cook bacon where I sleep. Well, bacon smells really good, but food in general, just I don't like to cook where I'm sleeping because it just makes it smell nasty. So I'll always be cooking outside, and with the AluCab camper, I'll have space on the outside to store food, and just set this right up next to the camper, food's right there, everything's in one place, we'll be good to go. So far, after a couple weeks now, I give this an A+. I've used it a couple times, really happy with it. Like I said, it is an investment, don't get me wrong. If you like to camp, if you like to go to the beach, we use it at the beach mainly, and if you're gonna use your stuff, it's worth it to get the nicer things like the partner stove, the trail kitchen. It's just nicer to have good, robust, well-built things that you're not gonna ever have to worry about. So again, do I feel that this trail kitchen is for everybody? No, I do not. It cannot be. It is a little expensive, but I think it's a fantastic quality. If you're looking for something like this, I think it'll fill your needs amazingly. It's a small footprint, relatively light when loaded. I think I weighed it at something like 46 pounds with all my stuff in it. If you want to see it, want to check it out, give me a holler. I'll be more than happy to show you. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up the video. Find us on Instagram also. We're roverlanding_Tacoma. And yeah, let us know what you think. If you guys want to see more content, let us know what you want to see. And we got more reviews coming out for you soon. Have a great day, guys, and get out and explore.